All right, thank you, Nick. Big news from the Centers for Disease Control today. The CDC says you can travel if you are fully vaccinated for COVID-19. While this is exciting news, health experts say to heed the warnings that cases and hospitalizations could start to rise again. Our Barrett Leone joins us live in our studio with more on the huge development and cautions from state health leaders. Barrett?
Tom, the same day this encouraging message from the CDC was given, Minnesota health officials reported a spike of more than 2,000 cases, a daily case increase the state hasn't seen in months.
A big step forward.
We state that fully vaccinated people can resume travel at low risk to themselves.
That message Friday from the Centers of Disease director.
This is a pivotal moment for our country.
But this pivotal moment comes with a cautionary flag.
And while we believe that fully vaccinated people can travel at low risk to themselves, CDC is not recommending travel at this time due to the rising number of cases.
Minnesota included. Friday, the state reported more than 2,000 new COVID cases, a daily increase that hasn't been seen since early January.
And we're definitely concerned.
Minnesota Department of Health's Chris Erisman credits this COVID spike to emerging variants.
We need people to realize that we are so close to being in a really good spot, but we're not quite there yet.
A message the president echoes.
Cases are going up again. The virus is spreading more rapidly in many places. Deaths are going up in some states. So I ask, I plead with you, don't give back the progress we've all so fought so hard to achieve.
MDH estimates 50 to 60% of Minnesota's virus spread is from variant B.1.1.7, also known as the UK variant.
There's a lot of good news, and we're really close to being in a much better place. But unfortunately, the variants have kind of come in like gremlins and are kind of putting a fly in the ointment. And so we have to take that into account as well.
Erisman also noted MDH is tracking other states that show similar variant circulation. Her team estimates that Michigan is about 2 to 3 weeks ahead of us, reporting more than 7,000 cases today, which is something that Minnesota experts are hoping to avoid. Tom.